creating so many overloads in the wide areas because you have Justin Miram so high on the left, you have Julian Gressel so high on the right. Bogusy's having to come back and defend. Blanco's having to come back and defend. And Atlanta United are moving the ball so well. So many options to be available for the ball.
Third corner of the early round.
Josef Martinez gets across. It's a great ball from Pitti Martinez, you have to say. Just watch how this thing dips. And Chara's caught out by the speed of it and the way that it comes in. Josef Martinez gets a touch on it. It comes off of Steve Clark, trying to react, does a good job just to get enough. It's a poor clearance from Cascante. He's off balance, trying to hook that one away. It goes right to Gonzalez Perez, taps it home, 1-0.
Well, the prior goal for him came on the 24th. Martin's going to be involved now, part of the Houston Dynamo ownership group. It's going to be a big, fun day. We hope you join us for the next 7.5 hours of live MLS. Here's Blanco from Valeri. Back for a bonus. Got away from Valeri. Back outside. Now it's Cross Fernandez. Flag comes up. So the call on the field is offside on Brian Fernandez on the would-be tying goal. Unless video review can show it was a clear and obvious error.
Valeri feels that Fernandez was behind the ball. This is tight. This was a great move. Oh, man. I mean,
but can you clearly and obviously say that it was onside from that video evidence?
No, not from that. I mean, that is so close because it's probably a shoulder versus a shoulder, but it does look like
hell in a way. To Portland, and he left as their all-time appearance leader and a winner in MLS Cup 2015. Valeri forcing a save out of Guzan. And safe there, reaching out with a hand. First stop for him tonight. Timbers goal.
That's a difficult one here for Guzan. We're actually seeing a Bogusy coming inside now more. He's playing almost as a second striker at times alongside Brian Fernandez. That opened up the 6-yard box there. He started a counterattack.
Continuing, it finds the path for Josef Martinez to a level coming across. Josef Martinez on the overlap to Gressel, went for goal. Ball got his body in front. Another early corner.
Well, this is the type of game from a neutral perspective that you hope for. I mean, it is end to end. Watch this little flick from Diego Valeri. Good night. Finding Villafana, tries to roll it across, a bit of a scramble, then Justin Miram says, okay, I'm going to take you on inside my 6-yard box, and then it goes straight down the other end, and Gressel tries to beat Clark at the near post. Hits the
free kick. Back for Atlanta, Valeri flipping it in, Cascante got it down in the middle, collision between Josef Martinez and Guzan. Blanco could not take advantage, though.
Oh, it's the second time, isn't it? It was Gonzalez.
That's why he didn't start any of the first 2 months of the season. He then controls that for Pete Martinez, reversing it for Josef Martinez. Gressel buzzing off as he cuts inside of Cascante. Pete, trying to find Josef again. Able to win the ball back from Zambrano. Pete Martinez, that was dipping. And Clark was happy to see it come up over the bar.
Just has the confidence to even take this strike on because he's going across goal. He's a little bit off balance. He gets the second one, beats Zambrano to it. And the option, he's a long way up here.
Players
at times for diving or playing for
Barron's interception. Barco on the run, he's in. Barco!
yep, I didn't score, so take some of that. Take a breath.
Up and up the last couple of years, and these two teams have been a big part of that for sure.
And I just got a text from Alexi Lawless. He says he thinks it's a penalty, so.
Well, there you go. And not to award a penalty or anything else to Loma's challenge on PT Martinez, who was streaming in right at the end of the half. Larry on top of Nagby, who just glides his way out of it. Here's Julian Gressel now. Gressel trying to find the angle for Josef Martinez. Boy, did he! And Martinez, what a goal! Less than a minute into the second half, 11 consecutive games played with a goal for Josef Martinez. And
the record continues, and the record grows for Josef Martinez. And this week, we talked to Josef Martinez. They said, what's it like having Barco and PT Martinez on the field with you? He said, I want to talk about the guys that give me the ball. And recently, it has been Julian Gressel. Just slots that pass, slices open this Timbers defense. And Steve Clark leaning to his right. Josef Martinez shielded, uses the defender as a shield, and bends it around. An absolute beauty into the top corner. That's up there with the best of them. Just made it look easy.
11 consecutive matches now, which is an MLS record. And, you know, listen, you sort of do this with a grain of salt and a little bit carefully. But for one...
FC versus Atlanta United, huh?
Oh, not the money on who's going to win, just for a matchup.
No, for who's going to be meeting in the final.
It's hedging a little
bit. But we all know it's MLS, so...
Blanco from distance, and Guzan, that ball was ducking, and we've scored... We've seen Blanco score those goals before. And Guzan able to get his body behind it for his third save tonight.
Well, I remember Blanco from a similar distance. What was it, Sporting KC?
Yep.
In the playoffs last year, put that one in the top corner, far post. This one's dipping. Guzan after said, whoo! He's moving. Does well to palm that one over.
Of the duels that they have won, their lowest this year in a home match, 49. Blanco from Josef Martinez looking for that decisive goal. A decisive tackle instead from Bill Tuiloma.
Well, Tuiloma leaving no doubt here.
Merrim, incredulous at Corey Rockwell.
I think he's got a case here, Justin Merrim. I mean, that's a... I thought that was a foul.
It's a corner. It's taken short. Valeri swinging it in.
Shuffle across to cover that post, then goes back the other way. Strong left hand to palm that away.
Giafani to the corner now. Those are in there for Portland. It comes to Valeri. Valeri trying to find space. Valeri! Comfortable fifth save of the night for Brad Guzan.
Actually, leading up to the shot, you can hear the shouts from Brad Guzan of release, release. He wanted his defenders to step up. Josef Martinez almost goes down the other end. And
now with a shout, slow to get up. We've got past the 4 minutes minimum. Herrera.
Get out!
We're trying to force him out into the middle. Valeri had it blocked by González Pírez. Ryan Fernandez is down. There's the final whistle. Wild, crazy night, but a victory for Atlanta United. An 11th consecutive game with a goal for Josef Martinez. A 12th shutout of the year for Brad Guzan. And Atlanta United, for the first time this year, first place in the MLS Eastern Conference. Philadelphia losing in Chicago yesterday despite playing the second half of a man. Atlanta with the win, and they own the tiebreaker.
And a game in hand.
Having been looking last place good. About a month and a half into this season, they were bottom of the East.
Above the red line's pretty good, right?
That they are now top. And Frank DeBoer continuing to this unenviable position, taking over the best and most fun teams, at least one of which we've ever seen in MLS history, guiding them on sort of a meandering scenic journey up to the top of the East. As for Portland, missing out on a chance to get a little bit of a gap there. They're still ahead of Dallas on the tiebreaker. They have two games in hand, but as we've said a number of times, from Minnesota to Dallas, 5 points, separating all those teams, seven of them, of which one is going to miss the postseason, to say nothing of anyone.